going to the end.
I know.
I know. I appreciate that. All right.
Mr. President.
Honey, how are you? And you just left home to come here.
Mr. President, it's good to see you. You're looking great. And we're going to do everything we can to make this program work. But the help of the man upstairs will do it.
Thank you.
Mr. President, patient glad the mayor will come see you.
It's good to see you.
And I bring best regards from all your supporters in Oklahoma.
Thank you very much.
We're going to be in there helping with this budget balance.
Thank you.
Good morning, Mr. President.
How are you? Good to see you.
Thank you.
You have a meeting for me, yes.
I do turn my law.
Yes.
Come back and see us.
I'd like to have it.
Mr. President, I'm able to talk.
I think we understand that this very same subject will balance budget. So I.
That's true.
May not be the best thing for television, but it's good.
Can everybody look this way, please?
Thank you. We really have given you a hot one.
Okay. Well, it's happier.
I was asking to take three or four.
Thank you, sir.
Participating, and as you know, when they first started talking about the balance, budget, even when you were talking about it, I didn't particularly agree with it at that point. But I have grown people who can balance a budget without somebody forcing them to do it. After my gig running the Chamber of Commerce, when we were the most conservative president we've had in the White House in years, when we got a Senate Republican control with conservative, we got boll weevils in the House, and we end up with $100 million deficit. I think it's time we do something about it.
Well, in all fairness, I have to say from our experience in California, because when I became governor there, we were in about the same shape the federal situation is. And yet there we have the balanced budget amendment. And there'd been a little finagling with the books to make it appear to get bad by the election year, the previous administration, without having to raise taxes. And so it fell to us when we got there. But I learned one wonderful thing about it, in all due deference to the Congress and what they're up against. When, you know, most of the causes are worthwhile, somebody comes in with this and the pressure mounts, and it's pretty difficult for them to say no. Well, in the period, having the amendment, and when you had no money at all because of this, you'd be surprised, and remembers how easy it was to say to the pressure group, the greatest answer in the world was to say, hey, look, there just is no money. And they didn't have any answer to that. And the first time that we came up with a surplus was the time when, bless him, Cap came to me, who was our finance director, Cap Weinberger, and said, we're going to have a surplus. We're out of the woods. And it was very early, about the second year. And he said, I thought maybe before everybody else finds out, you may have one of those things we've been saying no to as a favorite and like to get in the link. But I think the Lord was with me because I said to him, I do have a favorite. Let's give the surplus back. We made the announcement we were going to give it back before anyone else found out about it. And it worked. And that's what we did with it. But listen, thanks to all of you for what you're doing. And I know you're going over there at the East Room. I hope the air conditioning is working as well as it is here. And have some briefing on this. But today we make a big announcement out there in the steps of the Capitol, make the announcement before several thousand people and with all the co-sponsors and everything on the steps with us. And I feel the public is with us on it. And last night, I don't mean to get partisan here, but last night I saw a few lines from Meet the Press. Senator Krasner and Senator Hatch happened to be in a kind of a debate, but they only had a couple of lines, and I saw our old friend from California, Senator Cranston, saying what a ridiculous and foolish thing this was, and then charging that here I was presiding over the biggest deficit in history. And I saw how foolish it was now to be asking this. Well, you know, Senator Cranston has to be one of a little exclusive group of a half a dozen senators who, between them, have been the biggest spenders in the history of the United States in their advocacy and their promotion and their backing of spending measures. So I think we can say there's a certain amount of inheritance in this.
I said if Francis against it, I'm for it.
Pretty safe on
this. Mr. President, I think one other additional thing, there's a spending limitation in the amendment as well. I think that that's even more important than the balanced budget, because I find nothing thrilling about the budget being balanced at $1.5 trillion.
You're right.
So the spending limitation is very, very important.
Yes, but I remember Peck's bad boy of economics who won the Nobel Prize once said about the balanced budget, he said, I would rather have an unbalanced $200 billion budget than a balanced $400 billion budget. But the thing, all this talk and this propaganda that it is, that it's a gimmick and that it won't work, how do they explain that over 40 states have it in their constitutions and it works in those 40 states? Yes. California, the experts come in advance and predict what the revenues were going to be, and you submit a budget within those revenues. Submit a request for more revenues at the same time.
You know, the surplus, after you left, we had a surplus, and unfortunately, the most dangerous thing in the world is to give a group of politicians a surplus, and we rose to the occasion. We spent that surplus, so this year, for the first time, it went, and politicians will always rise to whatever level of money is available.
Well, you know, that's a wonderful example, because the year before, the last year in which we still had control of the budget, the surplus was $850 million. And my favorite story is of the Democratic senator who stormed into my office one day because we gave that back. And he stormed into my office and said, giving that money back is an unnecessary expenditure. But for last year, we had a $500 million budget. But just like in Washington, the new administration comes in the middle of the fiscal year. So there wasn't anything we could do about that one. We knew at the halfway mark when we left office that we were leaving a $500 billion, million dollar. See, I've only been here a little while. $500 million surplus, and that was just, there it was. The new administration came in, young Brown, they had the $500 million, it's long gone, and now they're faced with a tremendous deficit, and they've got a constitution that says they have to balance that.
Which was exciting for us this year. For the first time, our budget's less than the previous year.
Thank you very much. Appreciate your leading the parade on this
radio.
Without your leadership, then our president would not help.
That's right.
You're right about
I get there next month. I get there.
Okay.
Look at that.